if I could become vegan, somebody who was a butcher, somebody who, you know, somebody who was obsessive charcuterie, and somebody who, you know, served foie gras in the restaurant, if they could go vegan, I think that pretty much anybody could do it. I started working in kitchens when I was about 17 years old. I started working at the Keg Steakhouse as a dishwasher. And I got promoted to salad bartender and then quickly demoted back to dishwasher because I was pretty incompetent. But I love the kitchen and I love working in kitchens and I love cooking. So this was in Seattle where I got my start. And moved around from restaurant to restaurant, trying to get experience, trying to always get to like a better restaurant. And I felt confident enough to open up my own restaurant, doing new French cuisine. And yeah, that restaurant looked a lot different than this one. I served foie gras. I served veal, obviously. There was somewhere along the line where I started to get uncomfortable with my own menu and kind of uncomfortable with the exclusivity of fine dining. And so after a while and doing some soul searching, I started to realize that I couldn't ethically ledger what I was doing anymore. I went and shut down the restaurant and moved to Portland and retired from cooking. I remember I was eating a pizza. It was like some, you know, delivery crummy pizza that was like extra meat toppings and all the extra cheese toppings. So I'm eating it and I started to think about what was going on with what I was eating. And I couldn't escape it. And it was just going through my mind. Like I was seeing in my mind like whole cows going into giant meat grinders, you know, like in The Wall or something, you know. And I went outside and I threw up. I threw it all up. And that purging was transformative. You know, it was like, as I was retching, it was like a kind of an awakening moment. And I went vegan right then. And, but you know, I figured I was done with my culinary career. You know, I didn't know anything about vegan restaurants or vegan cooking or. My relationship to food changed a lot after I went vegan. I mean, first of all, I stopped looking at animals as food and animal products as food, so that was an obvious huge change. But that's remarkable for me because I was, you know, I did butchery. I used to slaughter animals in the kitchen, you know, used to slaughter rabbits and things like that. So that was a huge change for me. And the catalyst for all that change was all the way back in Florida when I had a restaurant serving foie gras and stuff, because I just went into the transition of working in a restaurant to owning a restaurant and just doing what I was taught and shown. But what really happens is that when you own your own business and you're responsible for purchasing, producing, and selling a product, and unless you're completely soulless, I mean, you're going to have a couple of concerns about what you are ultimately responsible for now. Now you're no longer just a foot soldier in a kitchen. Now you're the boss and you have to care about what you're doing. So when you take all that into consideration, then it becomes very real, and because it's your name on the bottom line. We're making new decisions every day. Like right now, we just got a new freezer because we're gonna start making our own vegan butter. So we're gonna stop using palm oil butter because it's not enough that we're just vegan. And you know, why are we shipping palm oil all the way from all over the world that's deforesting jungles and destroying orangutan habitat? You know, like how am I calling myself vegan and doing that? You know, so we have, you know, or how am I calling myself a good person or an environmentalist? You know, so I'm responsible for what I serve my customers. So I have to buy the right things. And that means a little bit extra work in order to make it good and make it wholesome and make it ethical. So be it. If I could become vegan, somebody who was a butcher, somebody who, you know, somebody who was obsessive charcuterie, and somebody who, you know, served foie gras in the restaurant, if they could go vegan, I think that pretty much anybody could do it. Yeah.